Hi guys, in this video today we're going to talk about how to graph the sine wave. And so we're going to learn all sorts of new things about graphing. These graphs are going to look different than any of the other graphs we've done before. And we're also going to talk about how to use your calculator. So let's talk first about your calculator, just so we can get that set up and get it ready to go. If you will go to your calculator, and if you will, first of all, let's start off by going to the mode. And in the mode, make sure you are in the radian mode. So if you are over here on degree, go over and click on radian, and hit enter. And now you are in radian mode. Next thing is, let's go ahead and go to y equals. And in the y equals, let's type in sine of x. And sine, we just use the sine button, which is right here. And then go to the X button, which is next to that green alpha button. And if you want to close your parentheses, you can. And then we have it in, that's what we're going to graph, is the sine of X. Before we look at the graph, though, let's set up our plot so that we can see what we want to see, and also set up our table so we can see what we want to see in our table. So let's start off with the graph. So go to the top. There is a button that says Window. Click on that Window button. Yours is going to look different from mine, but I can clear mine out and change it how we need to. What I want you to do, though, yours is probably negative 10 to 10, which is fine. Let's just leave it negative 10 to 10. But then go down to X scale, and let's change that X scale because we're going to do pies. We want to measure our X values in terms of pi. So let's do our X scale in terms of pi over 4. So if you hit your second button and your pi button, and then divide by 4. And when you hit enter, pi divided by 4 is 0.785, etc. All right, our Y values, I think you can leave your Y values the way they are. You're probably negative 10, positive 10 again, but then on your Y scale, again, you'll put 1 there, make sure that's a 1, and I think now yours should be set up the way it's supposed to be. So let's go back to our Y equals. Remember, we are graphing the sine of X. One more thing we need to do is the table set button. So go to second, and table set is right here with the shift of the window. So we go to table set, and we want to do the same thing with our table setup. Let's start our table at negative 2 pi. So use the negative button, not the minus button, but the negative button down here, and then 2 and shift pi, and we'll enter that, and it turns into a decimal for us. That's fine. And our change in table, let's set that up to be pi over 4 as well. So second pi divide by 4, enter, and once again that pi divided by 4 is 0.785, etc. All right, now let's go to graph it. To graph it, we're going to go to the zoom button. So click on the zoom button up at the top, and we want to choose zoom trig, so 7, or scroll down, whichever one you want to do, and now we have it graphing the sine wave. And if we look at our table is also set up, and it is counting in terms of, supposed to be counting in terms of pi over 4, which it is. So here's pi, and then go down to, and that's pi over 2, and there's pi over 4. Okay, now that we have our table all set up and our graph all set up, let's look at a couple of things. First of all, as I was doing that, I think you don't have to do that for the graph. I think once you do zoom trig, it will set up your graph correctly, but you do have to do it for your table, because if you don't do it for your table, you're not going to have, you're not going to be counting by pies, which is just not very useful. So look at a couple things. Look where it starts. It starts at the origin, 0, 0, and that's on our table as well. So at pi, it's at 0, and there's my cursor at pi and 0. At pi over 2, it's up there at 1, and then down at 0, it's at 0, 0 again. So the highest it goes is 1, and the lowest it goes is negative 1. And it hits the axis along the way. And it makes this wave pattern. Okay, let's go down to our paper now and talk about what's going on in this graph.